Hey guys, welcome back to another video. My name is Franco and you're watching the Franco Photo Vlogs. Today, we're gonna be installing the Sea-Doo BRP Premium Audio System on my 2020 Sea-Doo Fish Pro. Stay tuned, we'll do it together. I have decided that today is the day that I'm gonna be installing the speakers on my Sea-Doo Fish Pro. As you can see, it did not come with speakers. I got this thing for a pretty decent price, so the fact that I had to spend $1,200 on speakers sucks, but at the end of the day, I'm doing it. So let's do this together. All right, first thing we gotta do, remove this seat. There should be two or three screws, I forget, underneath here. Then there's some pop-up pins here. This panel comes off, and then we're gonna get to that. All right, so this is a 2020 Fish Pro, and like on all other Sea-Doo models, you pop off this back seat by pressing the two buttons on the side, and this will come off like this, and we're gonna have to get off these two screws here. Okay, let me get a little closer and show it to you. These two screws right here, and then these push pins come out, and that'll give us access to pull off those panels. My next step is pretty simple. So you wanna open up the compartment, okay? And this piece will actually just kind of pop right out. So as you can see, there are these little clips right here, and they just kind of sit inside these grooves. So you gotta kind of pull up on them. All right, and so that panel comes right out. I'll put this bad boy over here. I guess we'll work on one side at a time. I'm assuming next is gonna be these two screws here, but just stand by and I'll let you know in a sec. By the way, what you're gonna need for the two screws here, right, and these two here, is a T30 Torx bit. In case you guys don't have it, you can get these at Home Depot fairly cheap. I got this whole 37-piece socket set, and the Torx bit looks kind of like this, like that star. All right, you're gonna use a T30. All right, so now these should come out. Yeah, they came out pretty easy actually. So just these two screws here, right? The T30s. I'll set this to the side, and now I gotta get this off. So, all right. So I took out the two screws that were here. Okay, those are 8mm bolts, and basically this whole panel right here, what I did was I just grabbed it from both sides and I slid it forward, because the way it sits is actually in here with these clips here. So I'll set this to the side. Jesus, I need more space for panels. And we're gonna have to, I assume, take this piece off too. I'm not sure yet. And we're gonna have to run some wiring to this. Yeah, I think so. All right, what we got here? I open up the packaging, and this is wiring, two speakers. There should be some sort of hardware in here. This is the extra harness I needed. So take note of this, because this right here is the harness you're gonna need if you have, like me, the fish finder as well as the USB port. So I had dealership run wiring for the USB port. It literally comes out from under here and it connects here. That's really all it is. So it's taking up the two ports right now. So I'm basically adding another port for power for the speakers for the on the factory harness, which again is this right here. So pause the video and I'll read the part number off to you. 27800-3684, I believe the part number is. That's what it's saying, yep. So in this box we have some new hardware, and we have these two pieces right here. These two pieces are actually labeled right hand, left hand. You'll see right here, RH, right hand. This one's left hand. And those pieces are gonna go where these pieces originally went, okay? And they're gonna bolt up right up to these factory holes here. And that'll allow us to put the speakers mounted up straight into that. So let's put those on now. All right, so I just figured out that mounting this right here, let me get a little light on here. Oops, that's not the right color. Okay, so to mount these up, right, is bolt one and bolt two. It actually sits on here. So there's a little groove in there, right, like this. It actually sits on there. So you should feel that it doesn't rock back and forth. So I'm just gonna put this here, just kind of hand tighten it just a little bit so it doesn't move. And now this piece has to come off. So this piece will come off here just based on removing this one screw, which I believe is an 8mm, and then it should just slide forward like this nose piece did. Which screw did I pull out? Oh, I pulled out this one. What an idiot. Sorry. This one has to come out. Alright, so this piece, in my opinion, was a little bit annoying to get off of. So, basically, once you took that one screw off here, what you gotta do is you gotta slide this back in order to loosen it. So, kinda what I did, if you can tell here, you see these panels, these little screws? They kinda slide in to there, and they lock into place. So, rather than trying to rip it and tear it apart, what I did was my hand just kinda pushed like this, you know, to kinda loosen it up, and that's the problem child right there. So this has to come off. Again, not a big deal, but an annoyance nonetheless. And now I could screw these in. I could screw these in, and then I can lock the speaker in place. What I was trying to say earlier was this. See how this piece spins, but when it sits on the ledge, it doesn't go anywhere. All right, so this will give you a good look and a good time to sit here and clean this crap. Man, it got hot in this garage fast. Florida gets hot. All right, so I noticed that once you get these pieces in, you take off those two panels, the nose pieces off, you know, you clean it up a little bit. This is all set and clean. Okay, I noticed that the speakers are actually right hand and left hand too. So if you look, see how it says right hand? That one's gonna say left hand. So go ahead and install them and then we'll wire everything up. All right, so, this was the hardest part for me so far. Mounting this thing into where it's supposed to go is the absolute hardest part for me. So let me just show you what to do here, okay? I'll come around the other side and let me show you something. Let me get my light. So if you look here, it's kind of like a T-bar, a T-plate, right? So here's the slot, here's a slot. And let me show you. Let me show you on the speaker. Oops. Weird. Sorry. Let me show you on the speaker what goes there so you know how to put it in. Let me unwrap this. I'm gonna come outside where it's a little brighter. So you see that right there? This spot right here and this spot right here. That's gonna slide into that T-bar spot slot on the other side of the speaker. So let me see if I can show you how to mount that. Alright, let me see. Alright, so this is proving to be a little difficult. But I'm gonna try to show you. I'm gonna try. See if we could do this. Alright, so this essentially, get this wire out of the way, slide it up in here, and then slide underneath straight up like that. So now it's fixed in place. All right, so once you have your speakers mounted, okay? Once you have your speakers mounted, like so, you're gonna take the screw and it's gonna go right on top here, okay? To secure everything, and then we'll talk about wiring. All right, so let's talk about wiring, because I got those two screws in. The speakers are now in place. Now, most people with a Sea-Doo, unless it's a Fish Pro, are gonna have basically just one of these connected, okay? I have two because I have the USB port and I have the fish finder. So I had to buy this additional harness, okay? That is gonna take the place of one of these, essentially giving me one more spot. So I'd be using up all three spots, okay? So let's do this. Sorry, I'm doing this one-handed. Then this goes here. Okay, this goes like this. And now I have one more spot, and that's gonna be for the speakers. So we'll connect that. And And now in theory, if I did this right, which we'll confirm in a second, I should be able to turn on the ski and get power to all three. So I'm gonna try testing out my fish finder, my speakers, and my USB, and we'll see if it works. So let's power this bad boy up. Okay, let's power this thing on. Press and hold power. Nope, gotta turn this on first. Okay, so we got lights, which is good. Yep. Let's check out the Garmin. And we'll plug in my phone too. Garmin is working, so that's good. And now, what we're gonna do is plug in my phone and see if that works. Yep. So now all three pieces are working, which is great. And we'll pair up my phone and we'll test this bad boy out, see what it sounds like. Pull up your phone's Bluetooth. I didn't press anything on the speaker besides turning it on. I see BRP remote here. It looks like it's gonna pair. Yep, just got a confirmation. And let's get some audio going. Let's see what we got here. It actually sounds pretty good, but let me just get something with a little bit of a clearer audio. So, let's get some bass. Let's see.
Wow. Wow. That hits. I can imagine how good it's going to sound on the water. Holy crap. Yeah.
Before you run your audio for too long, make sure you're plugged into a battery tender so at least you got some juice from the wall.
Wow! Yo, this thing hits, bro!
Alright, that wasn't license-free music, so I guarantee you that I'm gonna get a copyright infringement for that. Hopefully not, because it was only a couple seconds. So, all right, cool. Let's put it back together. Just basically reverse all the steps, and I think we should be golden. All right, I'm bringing my camera with me. I'm doing a vlog on Sunday, actually. I'm riding out with the Florida Ski Riders over at Edmont Key. So, we'll have audio. Sick, bruh! Guys, thank you so much for watching this video. I appreciate it. I got all this information correct. I didn't even read the instructions. I kind of just watched someone else's YouTube video, and that's why YouTube University is amazing. So I figured I'd put my own twist on this video because I didn't see anyone who had any sort of instructions on how to do it with a Sea-Doo Fish Pro. So now you know how to do it exactly on a Fish Pro. If I missed anything, you have any questions about anything, leave me a comment down below. Please like, subscribe, comment, please, guys. I really appreciate it. I'm trying to grow this channel to 1,000 subscribers in 2022, because right now I'm up to 254, and I thank all 254 of you. Stay tuned. We got some awesome adventures coming. Thank you again for watching. I appreciate it. Have a great day, guys. Peace out.